So there are some rules to this game, right? What are the rules to this game? Rule number one is that I have the sole discretionary power on who I let ask questions. Is that clear? I'll be totally arbitrary on this, okay? That's one. And I have a great preference for small kids, okay? Great preference for small kids. So one, arbitrary rule number one. Arbitrary rule number two is that what we'll do is that I'm going to take questions in lots of three. Lots of three. So I'm going to say, raise your hands. Then we'll take question one, two, three. Then another, raise your hands. One, two, three. Is that clear? Clear? And the third and the most important thing, ask your question briefly, but ask a question for which only Mr. Premji has the answer. This is not a conversation with me, right? So you should never get caught into a situation where he says, Anurag, you answer this. Is that okay? Is that clear? Yes or no? Baat saaf hai. ऐसे सवाल पूछिए जिसका जवाब मुझे नहीं मालूम है, जवाब उनको ही आता है. ठीक है? ओके. ऑलराइट. सो वी विल स्टार्ट. लेट्स सी द फर्स्ट सेट ऑफ हैंड्स. और एक और बात है, बता सकता हूं मैं आप लोगों को कि ये सवाल जवाब जब हो रहा है तो इसमें कोई ऐसा नहीं है कि हमको केवल बातचीत करनी है विप्रो अर्थियन के बारे में. बात साफ है ना? थिंग्स आर क्लियर. You're not, it's not necessary that we talk about Wipro Earthian. It's not necessary that we talk about the environment and ecology. You have Mr. Premji here with you for 1 hour, roughly, right? So we can talk about anything that you want, which you think he will have answers to. Okay? Is it clear? Okay. All right, good. Let's see the first set of hands. Don't hesitate. I want to see the hands first, huh? I can see one hand. Just keep your hands up. No, for the first few arbitrary minutes, I'm going to take only students, no teachers and faculty, right? So I can see two hands. I want a third hand. Then I will go ahead. दो ही हैं आते भाई. कोई रुचि नहीं है बातचीत करने में. There is no interest. And shall we close the session? बंद कर दें session को. अच्छा चलो तीन तो हो गए. Okay. We'll go there first. One, two, and three. Is that okay? All right. Take the mic, speak clearly.
Good morning, sir. This is Akanksha from Post-Graduation Program in Sustainable Management of IIM Lucknow. When I was a kid, we used to make this chart paper on which on one part we used to make mountains and trees and clean river. And on the other side, we used to make industries and black clouds and everything polluted. We didn't know how to integrate the industries and the business and the nature. With time, we have come to a place where we know that we need to do it. And Wipro has understood that long back. I want to understand what motivates you to get into sustainability in business, because most of the companies are still not doing it. Consumers don't care that if the product is sustainable or not. What is cheap, we want that. And the businesses want profit. So what motivates you? What makes you think that sustainability should be a part of the business?
You know, I think apart from the fact that it's the right thing to do, there's also a profit motive in it. Conservation of water, which is very expensive, increases profits. Conservation of energy, which is very expensive, increases profit. Recycling of waste also increases profit because it reduces the disposable. So apart from the fact that it's the right thing to do for the environment, it's also profitable for us. And that keeps us going on an ongoing basis.
Mike.
Sir, apni chote belay kibhabe parashona korten, arthat koto shomoy dhore porten?
Kisi ko translate karna padega na, to mujhe Bengali aati hai na. Yeah, you are a Bengali, yeah. Yeah. Sorry. Huh? When you were young, how many hours did you study? Right?
Yeah. Yeah. No, I studied what a normal student studied, but I spent a lot of time outside the class on my knees. In those days, it was fairly conventional for the teacher to punish the students when they did not behave in the class. But I studied very intensively before the examinations, and I read a lot, which is a habit which I find today's children don't. They spend too much of their time watching TV. If you don't have time to read, at least have time to play games. Don't waste your time inordinately watching TV. It's a huge waste of time.
Thank you.
Yeah, should I translate this into Hindi, Bengali? Yeah. Hindi, Bengali? Yeah, is this okay? It's okay? समझ में? समझ में? तो आपको कोई इंटरेस्ट नहीं है क्यों क्यों उनको क्यों सजा देते थे? बाहर क्लास के बाहर हर समय घुटना टेक के बैठे रहते थे क्यों क्यों क्या करते थे वो?
Used to be korto.
Used to be naughty, I believe. Huh? She is saying you used to be naughty.
Yes.
He, wo haan keh rahe hain. Very naughty. Ask him. Very nice. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
okay,
sir.
Okay.
Good morning, sir. I'm Vivekta, and I'm from Lekol Champaka Trivandrum, which is in Kerala. So one question I would like to ask you is, recently, sir, you were conferred with the highest civilian honor in France. What were your feelings then? And what is one very important message that you would like to give to us, the youth, the college students, and us about sustainability? It can be anything, but one message you want to give us.
In the first place, I was not honored with the highest civilian award. The highest civilian award
you
is the Bharat Ratna.
Received an award in, no,
but
in
I did receive some civilian awards. I think the most important thing about sustainability is organizational commitment. You know, it cannot be done by one or two people. You have to motivate the organization, because sustainability carries far beyond the organization. You know, it carries in terms of switching lights off in your own home when you're not in a room. It carries about seeing to that a leaking tap is fixed, even temporarily, so that the water is not wasted. It means that have a bath with the minimum amount of water. So it has to carry into your life. Otherwise, it does not permeate into society.
Thank you. Okay, can I see the next three hands? Okay, I can see one, I can see two, I can see three. Huh? Array, that is very difficult here. Huh? Array, 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 array.
Let him go.
Okay, ek minute, because they, let me see the hands, then I will decide. One, two, somebody was there, no? Three, four. Okay, we'll start with you. Chalo.
हेलो आई एम अमित सर हमारे स्कूल हमने एक बार सर पॉलीथीन अपने स्कूल विद्यालय के 50 मीटर की रोड पे भी तो सर 600 से ज्यादा पॉलीथीन निकली थी तो सर इस पॉलीथीन को रोकने के लिए सर कोई उपाय नहीं है क्या
सो दे कलेक्टेड अराउंड देयर स्कूल दे वेंट अराउंड एंड कलेक्टेड द पॉलीथीन बैग्स एंड कितनी मिली
600 से ज्यादा
सो दे गॉट 600 मोर देन 600 पॉलीथीन बैग्स जस्ट इन 50 मीटर्स ऑफ देयर स्कूल सो इज देयर नो वे ऑफ स्टॉपिंग दिस होल पॉलीथीन मेनेस
You know, various state governments today have now put very strict rules on usage of waste bags such as this. I think the governments which are enforcing this seriously, it is working. But you have to appreciate the difficulties of not carrying purchases in a bag. So the substitutes are now gunny bags and waste bags, which are not polluting like plastic bags.
वो क्या कह रहे हैं कि बहुत सारे सरकारों ने राज्य सरकारों ने राज्य सरकार जानते हो ना तो राज्य सरकारों ने ऐसे नियम बनाए हैं जिसका इसका इस्तेमाल ना हो सके ठीक है तो उससे कुछ तो फर्क पड़ रहा है लेकिन उससे भी ज्यादा फर्क पड़ेगा अगर हम लोग कपड़े के बैग वगैरह इस्तेमाल करना शुरू कर दें और पॉलिथीन का बैग इस्तेमाल ना करें, ऐसा बोला।
पॉलिथीन बनाना बंद करवा दीजिए।
अब वही कहा उन्होंने, वही कहा। वो ये इनके कहने से पॉलिथीन बनाना बंद हो जाएगा?
सर आप लोग कोशिश करेंगे तो सर जरूर हो जाएगा।
हरिवंश राय बच्चन जी की कविता है, सुना है कभी? क्या कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती, सुना है? जाओ पढ़ो, अभी पढ़ना, ठीक है? अच्छा ओके, हु वाज हियर नंबर टू? या
नमस्कार।
अरे अच्छा ठीक है, वी विल गो टू देयर एंड देन।
मैं अमृता पाटिल सरकारी प्रौढ़शाले सामरा बेळगावी इंद बंदिद्देने। विप्रो संस्थे स्थापने ಮಾಡಲು ಕಾರಣ ಏನು?
Why was Wipro formed?
Wipro was first formed by my father in 1945. He had never had industrial experience before. He was in trading and he saw an opportunity in oil milling and refining oil. So we set it up in a producing area in Amalner, and we still have a plant there which is functional, but we have really diversified our portfolio. And we are very large in toiletries now in India and outside India, and very large in information technology through Wipro Limited.
Why do you do it?
ಅವ್ರ ತಂದೆಯವರು, ಪ್ರೇಮ್ಜಿ ಅವರ ತಂದೆಯವರು ಇದನ್ನ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅನುಭವ ಇಲ್ದೇನುವೆ ಅವ್ರು ಇದನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭಿಸಿದ್ರು. ಅಮಲ್ನೇರ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಜಾಗ ಇದೆ, ಇನ್ನೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಇದೆ ಅವ್ರದ್ದು. ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಐ ಟಿ ನಾವು ಏನ್ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ, ಮುಂಚೆ ವನಸ್ಪತಿ ಅಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ ಶುರು ಆಗಿ ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಈ ತಂತ್ರಜ್ಞಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಅವರು ಈ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ.
And I'm from Holy Angels IAC School, Kerala, Trivandrum, Kerala. And my question is, as the population is increasing, e-waste is also increasing, which is one of the factors that threaten Earth. So, how can we manage or control this e-waste in which people can even think of a life without gadgets?
As population is increasing, e-waste is increasing. E-waste meaning phones, computers, you know, televisions, stuff like that, right? So that's increasing. So what do we do such that this is in control, right? Yeah, okay, fine.
One very important thing is you should not waste. That's the first thing. Second is, you know, I think a lot of governments, a lot of cities have programs whereby e-waste has to be recycled, and it is getting reasonably well institutionalized and implemented. But I think the most important thing is that the manufacturers have to take the responsibility for being able to recycle second-hand equipment and not let them get into the environment. You know, we had a very major program where we were making computers, to recycle the computers in terms of removing all hurtful material in it in terms of a recycle. So it eventually becomes a responsibility of the manufacturer in terms of the recycle. But the states must enforce the laws.
You know what he's saying? When we used to make computers, when we'll sell the computers, we will take the responsibility of taking it back and making sure that it's disposed of responsibly. So what he's saying is that all manufacturers, it's okay. All manufacturers must do the same, and many of them do, right? So of course, that's where he started, that we should waste less. What should we waste less? We shouldn't keep buying phones, right? For example. But even more importantly, manufacturers must set up the a chain by which things can be taken back and disposed of responsibly. One, you are number one, okay? Number one. So I want to see question number 2 and 3. Can I see hands, please? 2 and 3. So 2. And are you a student? I can't see from here. Okay. So 1, 2, 3. Yes. Go ahead.
Good morning, sir. My name is Sonak Das. My question is, sir, ke bachpan mein sir aap kaun si subject pasand karte the aur kaun subject ke liye aapko punishment milti thi?
Mathematics and physics, they were my two favorite subjects because they really made you think.
Or punishment? What were you punished?
Chemistry.
वैसे बहुत लोग तो मैथमेटिक्स के लिए पनिश होते हैं, हैं? इनका उल्टा है. ओके, हु इज नंबर 2? समवेयर हियर ना? या नंबर 2 इज हियर. जस्ट फॉलो माय इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ वेयर टू गो. या नंबर 2 इज हियर.
ऐश्वर्या मुंडा फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट मॉडल स्कूल इन वेस्ट बंगाल. हम लोगों का जो स्कूल का सराउंडिंग है वहाँ पर बेसिकली ट्राइबल्स एरिया बेस करते हैं, तो उन लोगों का मतलब डेली लाइवलीहुड के लिए उन लोग जो फॉरेस्ट है बेसिकली उन लोग लाइवलीहुड के लिए वो कटिंग करते हैं बाय सेलिंग दो उन लोग उसको बेच के उन लोग डेली इनकम सोर्स करते हैं और उसका चलते ओवरग्रेजिंग भी होता है और उसका चलते बहुत मतलब फॉरेस्ट को मतलब नुकसान हो जाता है. हम लोग किस तरह से उसको उनका मतलब मेंटालिटी चेंज करके हम लोग फॉरेस्ट को सेव कर सकते हैं?
You know, this is a very difficult question to answer because there's a lot of livelihood which is determined by collecting wood and reselling the wood. I don't have an easy answer to it, frankly. What can be done is to retrain these people to get on to some other profession than trying to scavenge from the forest the waste wood. But the waste wood is waste wood. So if the regulations can be that the waste wood can be gathered and then used for fuel, it seems to be logical to me. But the livelihoods of a lot of people are dependent on that. You know, I remember in terms of when I go for treks in the forest, there's a lot of people who have earning and a livelihood by picking up the waste wood in the forest and reselling it. And you find all of these women and men carrying it on their backs and taking it to the bazaar for sales. Provided the wood is waste wood and is genuine waste wood, I think it is legitimate.
I can tell you 2 things. One is this, that perhaps those kind of issues that you're talking about are relatively the least harmful. Much greater harm is done by industry, extractive industries, and so on, right? So relatively speaking, that's less harmful, but it's a huge issue. What I wanted to tell you actually was that I think one of the world's absolute leading experts on this matter or these matters is Dr. Bawa there, right? So, I mean, in a room where Dr. Bawa is, I don't think any one of us is qualified to answer that question. So if you can catch him and Nitin, right, he's there, right there. If you can catch him, you should ask that question of him, okay? Please.
Oh, I mean, it's why don't you attempt an answer at this one, Dr. Bawa? Please give him the mic.
You know, he's one of the world's absolute leading authorities on this subject.
I will just say, it's a very complex issue. It varies from one place to another place. And I think it's in many cases, it's a myth that a lot of damage is done by people who sustain their livelihoods from the forest. But it is an issue. So I think that's what I would say. And in many cases, that use of forest can be made quite sustainable if we work with the people. And I think for a long time, this issue has been neglected and has become very mythical some people believe in one viewpoint and others in another viewpoint. But I'll be happy to talk with you later.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Bhava. Thank you so much.
Good morning, sir. I'm Aparna. I'm a master's in urban planning student at SEPT University, Ahmedabad. My question is, sir, you mentioned that you enjoy reading. Could you please share with us what are the books that you recently read, or what are the topics that you enjoy reading?
You know, unfortunately, I don't spend too much time reading fiction. And one of my ambition is to start reading a lot of fiction from middle of this year. But a book which I really enjoyed was by Satya of Microsoft recently, where he's talking about the whole question of empathy in management. I would strongly recommend that book. It's a very simple book to read and a very useful book to read. Okay, the name of the book, what is it called?
Sorry? Yes, Satya Nadella's book. Satya Nadella's book, which he's written, I mean, the only book that he's actually written. Yeah, but I can tell you that he reads a lot, a huge amount. And in fact, one of the most dangerous things in working with him is that what you write, you know, he reads it more than you do. So, you'll give him like 200 pages for a meeting and he will have 500 mistakes that he'll catch which you have made and you won't know that you made them. It's a very hard thing. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Agle teen sawal. Next three hands. Okay, I can see two. I want to see three. Yahan se aap logon ko yahan koi sawal nahi hai. Aur tumko kuch nahi puchna hai. Tumhare dost ne to puch liya. Okay. Can I see the hands, please? So I can see three hands already. All three are students. Okay, so hang on, I just keep your hands up because, yeah, I can see one more here. And so we'll go one, two, and three, the lady in red there, and then I'll come to you later, okay? Yeah.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Dasangu Mahato. I am telling about one question from you.
जो भाषा आपको ठीक लगती है पूछो, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, हिंदी मराठी.
आपको कब से नेचर के बारे में जानकारी प्राप्त हुआ? मींस
उनको नेचर कब से अच्छा लगने लगा,
अच्छा लगा.
है ना, ये पूछ रहे हो ना. हाँ, सो व्हेन डिड यू एंड हाउ डिड यू स्टार्ट लाइकिंग नेचर, द एनवायरनमेंट एंड थिंग्स लाइक,
व्हेन यू हैव अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट नेचर.
या गुड.
You know, my mother was very fond of walking. And as children, we used to hire a small bungalow in Mahabaleshwar, which is in Maharashtra, about 4-5 hours from Mumbai. And we would go for very long walks there into the forest. And that's when I really started enjoying walking in the forest and relishing the sound of the breeze in the forest and relishing the small animals which you came across into the forest. In those days, you could come across bigger than small animals. It was a very exciting experience. And I've kept that up right through. You know, I very often go for treks into the forest, spend maybe an hour, hour and a half, 2 hours in the forest.
Main Hindi mein translate kar dun usko? Kar dun? वो महाबलेश्वर नाम की एक जगह है. वो पूना से जो लोग आए हैं तो जानते होंगे अच्छे से, है ना. तो महाबलेश्वर नाम की एक जगह है जो बंबई के पास में है. तो छुट्टियों में वो अपने माता पिता के साथ जाते थे वहाँ, और उनकी माँ के साथ लंबे वॉक पे जाते थे पैदल चलने, 1-1.5-2 घंटे. तो वहाँ जंगल में जंगल देखते थे और छोटे छोटे एनिमल्स, लेकिन उस समय जो जानवर होते थे वो तो कुछ बड़े जानवर भी दिखते थे. तो वहाँ से उन्होंने ये सीखा. उसके बाद आज भी उनकी बहुत सारी छुट्टियां हैं वो इसी में गुजरती हैं. वो जाते हैं जंगल में, जंगल में 2-3-4 घंटे का वॉक करते हैं, ट्रैक करते हैं, उनको वही अच्छा लगता है. तो इस तरह से उनको नेचर से, नेचर की जानकारी मिली, नेचर से प्यार हुआ, नेचर से संबंध बना. ठीक है, Clear?
Thank you.
Okay, very good. Okay.
Morning, sir. My name is Siddharth and I am from Gwalior. I want to ask that what are few points that motivate a policymaker to actually think about sustainability? What are those few points which motivate a policymaker for sustainability?
Motivate who? A person who is supposed to execute the sustainability?
Yeah, both.
A person who is supposed to enunciate the policy for sustainability?
The person who is making the policies for sustainability.
You know, the policies are fairly simple and they're fairly universal for sustainability. I think the issue is that it should be pervasive in terms of its implementation. And I think many organizations realize that there is profit in sustainability. And that to any organization, apart from social consciousness, is the biggest motivator towards sustainability. And those profit equations should be clearly spelled out for people to really appreciate how much extra profits they can generate from lower carbon emission, from better water usage, from better disposal of waste, etc.
She was there, but before you give that mic, you know, I think one part of the answer is what Ms. Premji said. The other part of it is that I think we need to have civic action. We don't have civic action enough, right? So, I mean, unless we have civic action, unless all of us are engaged, and that applies for multiple kinds of issues, you know, not just the environment, but certainly for the environment, that unless we have civic action, and civic action of both kinds, which is around you, and civic action of a political kind, right? So unless we do those, both those things, things are not going to move as rapidly as actually is required. You know? And again, if you people have the time, I think you need to talk to my friend Vishwanath there, who has led some of the most remarkable things, I think, in this city or around this city on how to generate civic action around the matter of water. You know, all of you must have been hearing about this whole water thing, that their lakes in Bangalore are burning. You've heard of it? Like lakes in Bangalore are burning? You should talk to Vishwanath about what he has done in Jakur. Right? It's unbelievable that in the same city you can have lakes burning and you can have a lake like Jakur, which is a big lake, the Ratchanalli Lake and the Jakur Lake, which are beautiful, absolutely exquisite. You know, I don't know, he will be able to say it, but I think the pristine quality of it is really restored. So I think civic action is absolutely critical, and you young people here must lead civic action. Yeah?
I'm just asking you to ask these water questions.
He's known as the Rain Man. Yeah.
Hello, I'm Navya. I'm from Bangalore. And while we're here talking about sustainable systems, I want to know what it means to be a sustainable individual. So what I've realized is, as college students and school students, we're part of systems that require us to conform in some ways. And what happens is that often leads to us becoming passive. There's a system that's telling you what to do. So you tend to become a little passive because sometimes it's easier and sometimes that's all you can do. And that also means that you, over time, you stop being able to think. And you stop being able to think, you can't question. And that means you can't adapt or change. And that means you become unsustainable as an individual. So I just want to know, in today's system, what does it mean to be yourself? What does it mean to have the courage to be yourself? And yeah, sustain yourself.
The answer is very simple to this. You need to have the courage to be yourself. Nothing beyond that.
I want to see three more hands. No teachers, please. No teachers. So I can see one hand here. Yeah, that I know. So. One, two, three. Is that a hand? It's not a hand. Hand has to be a proper hand. Okay. Yeah. You're surely not a student. Sorry? Wiproites. Yeah. Wiproites are prohibited from asking questions. Absolutely prohibited from asking questions. Okay. So, actually, you know, I feel like his response to your question was so appropriate and brief that the only way is to have the courage to be yourself. So I'll tell you something about him. Okay, not right now. Let me go through these three questions, then I'll tell you something about him. One, two, and somebody else was here? Yeah, sorry, three. We'll go, one, two, three, okay?
No, tell me something about myself, I'm curious.
Really? Yeah, you know, my colleague Narayan there, right? We were more or less at the same time in engineering college. Very many years ago, right? I look very old, isn't it? So it was like many decades ago. And the thing is that people like me and Narayan, do you know why we joined Wipro? There were companies that were paying higher salaries. Huh? Yeah, it never mattered. Does anybody know why people like me and Narayan would have joined Wipro 30 years ago? Yeah, because of Mr. Premji, but because of a particular thing, one specific thing. See, for those of us who were wanting to go and join private sector companies, I'm talking about the mid 80s, late 80s, early 90s, it was impossible to think of a private company that had integrity in a particular way, that did not bribe. Right? Do you understand? My other old-time colleague DJ is there, Deepak Jain, right? So all of us who have joined 25, 30 years ago this company, a lot of us said, look, it's okay, the salary is fine, you know, and the work we'll deal with. But this is a strange company where, you know, you are clear from the very beginning that you can lose a 50 lakh order, a 50 crore order, but you will not bribe a 50 naya paisa, 50 paisa, huh? Right? So people like DJ or Narayan or me, we joined this company because of that. Now after 30 years, and you know, I joined the company straight out of college, right? So I've been through everything in this company. I can tell you, in 30 years, never ever have been any ambiguity. Koi duvidha kabhi thi hi nahi. You should only do the right thing. Always. Right? And that comes from him. Right? So he has always stood like that, saying, business mein success ho ki nahi ho, wo dusri baat hai. Wo dekhenge baad mein. Lekin kabhi integrity compromise nahi karenge. Right? And that is the courage to be yourself. Right, and today it's very easy for me to say, it's, you know, because he is what he is, Wipro is what it is, you know, we are such a large company, so successful. So, you know, if somebody is, most people don't ask us for bribes, they won't ask us for bribes. Even if they do, we can say, no, we don't do such things. But imagine this in 1973, 74, 75, 1966 when he began his work. And, you know, people like Narayan, DJ and me, we are, you know, we've been brought up on these stories on how we have run. You know, there was a point in time where somewhere in this country, there was a particular factory that we had set up. And that factory, we were not able to get electricity connection. Guess why? Can you guess why? Because they were asking a bribe. So he said, no, we will not give bribe. We either will not run the factory or we'll run it on a generator. So we ran the factory for 18 months on a generator, right? We did not bribe. Right? So, I mean, everything else aside, now everything else aside for this company, which is an incredible company, the greatest pride that all of us have is that we've been absolutely uncompromising on integrity. And that is the courage to be yourself, right? Okay. So I thought I should, is that okay? Yeah, one. So two and three. I'll come to you, two and three, yeah.
Sir, who is your greatest inspiration and what aspect did that person, he or she, change in your life? What change did it bring in your life? I'm Ganga. I'm from Lekol Champaka, Serene Valley, Kallem, Trivandrum, Kerala.
You know, if you were to ask me who is one person who's been my greatest inspiration, I think it has been Mahatma Gandhi. And what I've learned from him, which is very pervasive in my life, is the trusteeship of wealth. You know, wealth does not belong to you. You're a trustee of that wealth, and you should use the wealth for social good.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, sir. I'm Saidi from School of Planning and Architecture, Delhi. I'd like to ask that, what is your view on e-mobility? For example, if we take the example of metro, it is doing emission in one part of city for generating electricity, and in the other part we are saying it is doing no emissions. So what would you like to say?
What's your view on what?
E-mobility.
What is e-mobility?
Electronic mobility. Matlab, whichever...
Are you talking about electrical vehicles?
Yeah,
vehicles.
It is the example. Yeah.
Okay. What's your view on
metro? Which runs on electricity.
So what's his view on electric vehicles?
Yeah.
Electric vehicles.
I mean, like, you know, your question has the answer, which it depends on where the electricity is coming from, isn't it?
But in one part of city, we are saying that it is generating no emissions. And in the other part, it is generating emission for the same electricity, which we need for the other part.
No, so, you know, you go back to the source of that electricity. There are various sources of electricity which are very environmental friendly, including electricity generated from hydraulics, from water, from wind, from solar. And the good thing about our country is that there has been a strong emphasis on using these unconventional sources of energy, solar and wind. Solar and wind today account for something like 7 or 8% of our total energy consumption. And at the rate that they are growing, they will account for 20 to 25% of our energy consumption. Water generated electricity accounts for about 15-20% of our power generation. And that is clean electricity. One is in the generation of electricity where you try to get as much environmental friendly power as possible. Second is the electric vehicles are certainly very, very soft on the environment. Technology is very complex. You require charging stations for them. They cost much more today, but it's an inevitable trend. More and more of the vehicles will be electricity charged, or they'll be hybrids, part petrol, part recycled electricity, which you get through the system of the flywheel of the vehicle. It's a good trend, and India can be one of the leaders in this trend.
Hello, sir. I'm Harshini. I'm from Bangalore. I'm an architecture student, and oftentimes in our design studios, we're taught about sustainable methods. But one thing we all know is that affordability controls our actions more than anything. And a lot of times people have strong notions that most methods of sustainability come at high initial costs. How do you think this notion can be driven away such that it's more cost friendly and also it opens up to a larger crowd? And how do you think companies such as Wipro, that's already incorporating so many sustainable methods, can contribute to this situation?
No, but any sustainability in architecture, if purely implemented, reduces cost. And you know, sustainability can be in various forms. One is in the use of power just through more natural lighting. It can be in the use of more efficient electric consumption. It can be in the use of more friendly and more scientific air conditioning. It can be in the use of having spaces in a facility which are natural, which through a blowing system of air can bring temperatures down very significantly. You know, a typical example of a real showpiece in sustainability is the campus we have set up in Kudathi at Sarjapur. It's already partly occupied, but it'll be completed by June of next year. And we would welcome groups of young students to visit us there because we can demonstrate to you in actual form and actual implementation how we have converted a highly power intensive facility like a software facility into one which is not power unintensive, but is significantly more power efficient. More power efficient. For instance, you know, our foundation office has only one air conditioning system that's in the conference room. The rest is natural, and appreciated that in summer it gets a little hot, but it is tolerable, and the rest of the year it's very, very comfortable.
Okay, so here's the thing, that we have got about 5 minutes more, right? So with 5 minutes more, I want to see. Just keep your hands up, please. Keep your hands up, please. So see, because we have 5 minutes, we're going to do a rapid fire. Do you know what a rapid fire is? No. Yes. You know what rapid fire is. Okay. So if you know what a rapid fire is, the way we'll do a rapid, this is a reverse rapid fire, which means the questions have to be rapid fire. Okay. He can respond at length, but the questions have to be rapid fire. Okay. All right. So raise your hands again, please. All of you. There was some hand here. So we'll go 1, 2, and 3. Okay. 1, 2, and 3. And then we'll see if we have time. Okay. Here.
Good morning. I'm Shonali Jana. I'm from Kolkata. And my question is, if any noble person from West Bengal had inspired you?
You know, I think, and this is very unconventional, but your current chief minister is a very inspiring lady. She is. She tells it as it is. There are very few politicians who have the guts to tell it as it is.
So, aap didi ko bata dijiyega jaake. Okay, who was number two? Who was number two? Here, right? And then number three there. Number two.
Sir, mera naam Aman Kumar Verma hai. Main Sasaki Uchchatar Madhyamik Shala Pahanda, Raipur, Chhattisgarh se aaya hu. सर मैं पढ़ाई करके आपके विप्रो कंपनी में काम करना चाहता हूं सर इसके लिए मुझे क्या करना होगा
वेरी सिंपल यू अप्लाई टू अस एंड वी विल गिव यू अ फेयर हियरिंग एंड इफ यू क्वालिफाई यू विल गेट अ जॉब विद अस ऑन मेरिट्स इट विल बी ऑन मेरिट्स प्योरली ऑन मेरिट्स
थैंक यू सर
Hi sir, my name is Sania Mirza. Our school name is Sundarban Janakalyan Sangha Vidyaniketan. My question is, how can we waste the drinking water? Drinking water in the rural areas in our Sundarban areas. How can we take help me?
How can we take?
For me. Sorry. How can we take for you? You.
How can we help? Or how can we get help from him?
Him.
अरे ये तो बड़ी मुश्किल बात है भाई. वो सुंदरबन में कैसे मदद करेंगे आपकी?
सुंदरबन जी
क्या है? South of Calcutta, West Bengal.
You write to us. Let us see what we can do.
लिखिए कह रहे हैं आप. Write to him. Yeah? Okay. वैसे मैं आपको एक बात और सकता हूँ. That's an interesting point, which is that there is an organization called Wipro Cares. Wipro Cares works with communities around places where Wipro has large operations. Calcutta is a place where we have large operations. So in Sundarbans, we have done a water project because we are familiar with the water problem there. So it might actually be a good idea not to write to Mr. Premji, but to write to Abhijit, who's just going outside. Huh? Okay, so you write to him and he'll tell you what you've been doing. Okay, catch him.
No, but so far as your school is concerned, you know, we have a very interesting program of financing fellows who want to be setting up school enhancement operations. If you write to us on that, we could certainly consider giving fellowships to a person who's willing to work with your school and surrounding schools. Even though we don't have a footprint there vis-a-vis the foundation, we could have a small footprint there vis-a-vis the fellows we finance for a period of 3 to 5 years.
Abhijit ko pakadiye, theek hai? Okay, so we are almost done. Wait, where is that?
And the small kid.
Oh, yeah, behind the camera. Ha, theek hai. Okay, so my friends, 1 minute, huh? My friends, 1 minute. We will probably, that'll be the last question that we take, huh? Because we're almost done. And before we end, one minute. One minute. So before you ask your question, so this is going to be the last question. If you have questions, and particularly my friend there, right? Why don't you write? He always responds to his mails, right? So why don't you write? You can write to him, write to me, write to anybody, and I will make sure that you get responses. Okay? You can write to anurag.behar@wipro.com. You can write to azim.premji@wipro.com. Okay?
What's the gas balloon in your campus?
What is that?
What's the gas balloon in your campus?
We just saw the gas balloon plant in your campus. He's been troubling us, asking us, what is a gas balloon plant doing in Wipro? Does it go up?
Do you have a gas balloon plant?
Sir, thank you.
It's a...
Can we ride on it?
Ride on the gas balloon?
Yes.
There's a gas balloon.
I actually don't know. And he also doesn't know. So we do, both of us don't know what you're talking about.
You have a gas
balloon? So near the biogas plant, there was a gas balloon.
So we know that there's a biogas plant. And by the way, biogas is one of those sustainability initiatives that we take. Yeah. But both of us are quite unaware that we also have balloons now in our campus.
He actually read gas balloon plant. So I'm a very excited mother right now. So he could actually see gas balloon plant and he was super excited. And he said, please ask Mr. Azim Premji, sir, what is it? So we are really intrigued. What is a gas balloon plant?
So actually, neither of us know. Yeah. And we can also end on this note. And this is for students particularly, right? That there are things that Mr. Premji also doesn't know, right? And there's no harm in admitting that, right? So whenever you don't know something, we're wrong about it, admit it, you know? That's how you move forward in life. Is that okay? Okay. All right. So shall we thank Mr. Premji first and then thank all of you. Thank you so much.